Did you know that the spirits of the dead can attach themselves to us and drain our light and energy? More about that in a few minutes. What is spiritual cleansing? Spiritual cleansing is a purification process of body, mind, and soul. The vile flame cleanses us. However, there are other kinds of cleansing as well that are more like a thorough scrubbing of your deepest layers, if you will. And to get access to that kind of deep cleaning, which I call spiritual stripping action, we need to get acquainted with a very high spiritual being, the Elohim Astrea. So what does Astrea do for us? To answer that question, we first need to know who Astrea is. I'm going to introduce her to you and tell you about her decree. And as a bonus, I'll share a wonderful video that shows Astrea's powerful energy patterns in action when we give her decree. So who is Astrea? Mighty Astrea and her twin flame purity are Elohim. The seven Elohim and their twin flames are the builders of the universe. They carry a tremendous light that we as humans can barely comprehend. And yet these great divine beings know us intimately and want to help us reach our highest potential. Astrea and purity are the Elohim of the fourth light ray, the white ray. This is the ray of purity, order and harmony. The white ray is also the flame of the ascension and represents God as mother. Astrea and purity use the white ray combined with the blue ray to create a very special stripping action. So, let's talk about cleansing. Cleansing means that we purify ourselves. We get rid of all the bad and negative energy that is within our being. Imagine you just took a mud bath. Everyone that ever took one knows that as soon as the mud is dry after the bath, it's really hard to get it off. It can even hurt to scrape it off your skin. You need a shower and some good soap to rub it off you completely. This is similar to what happens in our spiritual bodies. In the course of the many lifetimes we've had on this earth, and that could be hundreds of embodiments, we've accumulated lots of mud, lots of negative things. For example, it is possible that we were cursed by a witch in another lifetime. We might still have that curse on us in this lifetime or even hundreds of years afterwards, and this could have caused negative experiences such as unexplained accidents in our lives. Now, you may not be familiar with the term I'm going to talk about, but there's something called entities. And these entities can influence us in some pretty negative ways. So here's how this works. You know that as human beings, we often develop bad habits that can be detrimental to our health and well-being. For instance, take smoking or drugs. When we engage in these things, we are in fact using a portion of the life energy God has given us to develop these negative habit patterns. We use this vibrant, creative energy and funnel it into a negative, destructive habit. As strange as it may sound, that habit pattern that we are creating can take on a life on its own, since we're feeding God's creative energy into it. Once these semi-conscious beings are born, they become an entity, a living thing. And that living thing wants to continue living, which it does by encouraging people to continue in their negative habits. That's because when we engage in these destructive habits, we create cracks or rents in our chakras. When that happens, they are easily drained of the light we store there. And so, when an entity encourages someone who's addicted to nicotine to take another smoke, that person's chakras are drained. The smoking entity lives off that light and gets stronger and stronger until the person is completely depleted. When an addicted person passes on, the entity lives on for quite some time and looks for other people to leech onto so it can continue to exist. It sounds gross, but most people have dozens or even hundreds of entities attached to them that try in one or another way to get access to our light. Yikes! And to make matters worse, we are also dealing with what are called discarnate spirits. These are the souls of people that have passed on, but they've got so little light that after their transition, they can't make it to the heaven world. So they roam around in the astral plane. These discarnates can also attach themselves to living people for the same reason. They want to live, but they don't have their own source of spiritual energy. So they siphon off light energy from living people by causing people to do things that cause rents in their aura or chakras, such as engaging in crimes or outbursts of violence and rage. They get access to our light. And then there are demons. These are the spirits of really evil people and of fallen angels who are at war with the light bearers. To get rid of these kinds of evil influences, entities, discarnates, and demons, we need something stronger than the cleansing power of the vile flame. We need the powerful assistance of the Elohim Astrea, who has promised to cut anyone free from these influences who prays to her. Think of it as a kind of infallible exorcism process that can liberate us from these negative influences that we can't even see. Here's another example of what Astrea can do for you. You might be blinded by another person. Through karma and certain psychological patterns of many, many lifetimes, you might find yourself in a relationship with someone who just treats you very, very badly. They might even be violent towards you. And yet you are unable to separate yourselves from them. Astrea can help. She can cut you free from the ties that bind you to this person. Another energy that constantly impacts us is the mass consciousness. Let's explain this with a recent example, COVID-19. Many people were scared when the epidemic erupted. Because we're all connected to each other energetically, you might have been affected by this fear. If you live in a big city surrounded by many people, it is likely that you felt lots of fear because of COVID. But the fear wasn't necessarily yours. You could have picked it up from others. They could have influenced your consciousness without you being aware of it. Most people are not protected against these thoughts, frequencies, and feelings from others. They just pick them up and they don't know this energy is not theirs. They think it is theirs and they live these feelings as if they are real. So you might have been really scared of getting COVID during these times, even though you're not an easily scared person. This simple principle applies to all kinds of thoughts and feelings that may be harbored by other people around us. You could get infected by feelings of hatred, ingratitude, money obsession, etc. that other people carry around in their auras. A good way to look at these negative energies is a kind of mass entity. These mass entities are literally all around us, especially in the cities. But the good news is mighty Astrea can cut you free and protect you from these negative vibrations. One more important example is the following. Imagine you had an ugly disagreement with a friend. You defend your opinion on something and this friend didn't like it, therefore attacked you, so to speak. You might be feeling this energy from your friend on you for days or even longer. This friend sent you some pretty nasty and misqualified energy and probably is still boiling after your disagreement. That is energy that's being sent your way. It might affect you negatively because you are not protected against it. You might be experiencing all of these feelings of hatred, intolerance, and ungodly feelings towards him or her as if they were your own. But in reality, they might be just the feelings of your friend who is sending them towards you, intentionally or unintentionally. However, as in the COVID example, it feels like it's yours. This can distract you from your daily tasks because it's a very penetrating energy that just doesn't want to let go of you. It can make you feel very angry towards that person and can also make you overreact in other situations. Depending on the intensity of the energy, this really could make you feel like you're on the edge. It wants to fill your entire being and wants to stay with you forever. At some point it probably wears off, but who wants to have that kind of energy dominating your emotions and physical being? Mighty Astrea can cut you free from this energy within a very short time. So far so good. I'm sure you can see Astrea as a very powerful heavenly being. But maybe you tell me, Simone, I don't have any addictions or unhealthy habits. I'm pretty healthy and have a healthy lifestyle. So why do I need Astrea's when using the vile flame? First of all, Mighty Astrea has said that in order to receive her protection and cleansing, you should invoke her presence every 24 hours by giving her decree. This is not unusual because many ascended masters have said that we need to renew heavenly energies that we draw down into our world every 24 hours. In order to understand what Astrea can do for us in connection with the vile flame, let's first review an explanation by Saint Germain about what the vile flame all by itself does for us. He said in a dictation, "That vile flame that you have invoked has been directed into the most resistant and recalcitrant pockets of your own subconscious, especially into those conditions which you have been the most desirous to have removed. Therefore, in some of you, a hearty amount of karma has been balanced. In others, hardness of heart has truly melted around the heart chakra. There has come a new love and a new softening, a new compassion, a new sensitivity to life, a new freedom and a new joy in pursuing that freedom. Blessed ones, it is impossible to enumerate exhaustively all of the benefits of the vile flame, but there is indeed an alchemy that does take place within the personality. The vile flame goes after the schisms that cause psychological problems that go back to early childhood and previous incarnations that have established such deep grooves within the consciousness that in fact they have been difficult to shake lifetime after lifetime. Okay, now that we understand a bit more what the vile flame does in us, let's look at Saint Germain's explanation of why we need Astraeus in addition to the vile flame. He said, "It is noteworthy, therefore, that as the vile flame has liberated in you certain God qualities, so it will also flush out and bring to the surface, as alchemists know and refiners, the dross of human creation. If therefore there is not called forth an intensity of sacred fire through calls to Astraea for the clearing of that substance, the vile flame may have the action of bringing to the surface that substance. And because you do not finish the service that is needed and you do not understand what service is needed, you may have lingering in and around your being those momentums of the human consciousness that seem to rise up and to frolic and to cause you to be somewhat out of alignment by the new freedom that you feel, no longer being heavily bound by your karma." To step that down a bit, Saint Germain is saying that after you took that mud bath, and the mud has dried and caked onto your skin, you started using the vile flame to get rid of these layers of mud on the surface. This makes you feel free and cleansed. But in reality, let's say that during your mud bath, you swallowed a lot of mud that still sits inside your whole body and can keep you from expressing your fullest potential. Mighty Astraea's decree is like the best scouring pad possible to clean you up from the inside out. She gets into every single place of your being and cuts you free from all these old records and patterns you no longer need. She clears away these dirty parts inside yourself that you otherwise couldn't reach. I mentioned in another video that Elohim Arcturus and Victoria, who are the Elohim of the seventh light ray, the violet ray, called the vile flame a wonder drug. Drug referred to medicine. However, let's imagine for a moment that the vile flame has a similar effect as laughing gas or nitrous oxide, but without any negative side effects. This laughing gas, which is also called happy gas, can make you feel euphoric, relaxed and calm. It can make you laugh a lot, hence the name. Imagine that the effect of laughing gas can be felt for 24 hours and you have to take a school exam a few hours after having inhaled that gas. This would most likely not be beneficial for you because you'd be probably laughing about the exam questions and couldn't be serious about it. As a side note, that's what I imagine it would be like, though I don't have any personal experiences with it. The same thing can happen with the vile flame. Imagine you're someone who is usually very timid and anxious. The vile flame, however, makes you feel courageous and strong, and after you've used it for a while, you feel like you can do anything. Now you go for a walk outside and it's raining. There's a huge pothole full of water. Because you're full of light, you think you can conquer everything, including this huge pothole. You start running and jump and land right in the pothole. This self-overestimation was caused because the vile flame set you free from all these limiting feelings. However, because you were missing Astraea's white and blue fire that tackles the core of the negative patterns that reside deep in your subconsciousness, it all ended up in you being completely drenched and probably also somewhat embarrassed. I hope my simple pothole example makes it clear why the recommendation to all of us is to use Astraea's decree. Many of us are simply not aware of what's going on deep inside of us in the subconscious, and also not of how strongly we're actually being influenced by other people and by nefarious energies and entities around us. But it is just wonderful that we have this powerful heavenly friend who is here to help us. All we need to do is invoke Astraea into our world on a regular basis by giving her decree. So where can we find Astraea's decree? I will add a link to an Astraea video below this video. This is a video with decree text that invokes Astraea at a slow pace that's good for a beginner. It's a complex decree, but if you follow along with the video, you'll figure it out. Okay, now you know why to use the Astraea decree, but what should you visualize? The Summit Lighthouse Encyclopedia says the following. "The circle of blue fire invoked from the heart of Astraea is a dazzling blue-white fire that oscillates as two concentric rings of fire, the blue of Astraea, the white of purity. interchanging frequencies at such a rapid rate so as to appear as the action of blue-white lightning flashing around souls, planets, solar systems, galaxies, wherever there is a need for the reinforcement of the will of God in the divine blueprint held in the white fire core of being. One very talented Chila of Mighty Astrea has created this visual to the degree that you can use. I strongly recommend invoking Mighty Astrea every day so you can have the greatest benefit of her liberating presence and her stripping action in your life. I hope this video was of value for you. Please give me a thumbs up and recommend my channel to others that might be interested. Thanks so much and have a great Vile Flame day!